Hi everybody! So we're going to do a geometry lesson today called lines. So some of you have had this, but let's just treat it as a refresh if you need it. So this is a line, okay? And this line is going from side to side, like this. So when a line goes side to side, have you ever been to the ocean or to a really big lake? Looked across a really flat field and you could see where the land almost looks like it's touching the sky, or where the water almost looks like it's touching the sky? Do you know what that's called? You're looking at the horizon. So a line that goes from side to side is called a horizontal line. Okay, now here I have a line. It's going up and down, like a skyscraper, straight up and down. When a line goes up and down, we call that vertical, a vertical line. Now here, I have a line. It's not going side to side or up and down. A lot of people call this a diagonal line. Well, we have a very special and proper name for that, and that's called oblique lines. Oblique lines. All right. So these are three types of lines. Horizontal, going from side to side. Vertical, going up and down. And oblique, just going diagonal. I want to look at two other kinds of lines. Here, I have two lines that are crossing one another. We call those intersecting lines. They are intersecting one another, kind of like an intersection. You know, when two roads come together, make a T, you stop at a red light or a stop sign, and intersecting lines. And there's one other one that some of you may recognize. Well, it does. This. Or, in fairness, it could also do this. Doesn't matter either way. This is called perpendicular lines. You see how it makes almost like the corner of a rectangle? If I did this and this, like it's making a rectangle. When two lines come together and make that perfect L in the corner, that's called a perpendicular line. For those of you who have had angles, it's coming together and it's making two right angles. Okay? All right. So what I want you to do is I want you to try to find a way to make a piece of art using intersecting lines. And tomorrow we're going to talk about elements of art lines, and we can talk more about that. But for now, these are the geometric terms for these different kinds of lines. I'm going to put some examples of possible follow-up work that you can do at the end of the video, just with some pictures, okay? And I have a little story for you. We're gonna use our little dudes over here to help us. And so we're all set up and we're ready for our story. Here are two lines that start here and they're slowly coming together. So it's like if two friends were on a walk and they were happy because they knew when they got to the end of their walk, they would be together and they could have a play date. So these guys are happy. Now these two friends here are starting at the same spot. And instead of going on a walk and meeting each other at the end, they're actually separating. So they are sad. Now these two lines, there's two friends on a walk, but these two lines don't ever come together. So they don't really know that they're missing their friends. So they're not happy or sad. They're just kind of chilling, right? So two lines that come together are called convergent lines. And two lines that go apart, oopsies, are called divergent lines. and two lines that go on and don't ever, ever, ever come in contact with each other, and they're just perfectly right alongside each other, are called parallel lines. So convergent lines, converge means to come together. Diverge means to go apart. You see that root word verge, vergent in there? And then parallel lines just run right next to each other forever and ever and ever. They don't ever come in contact and they're perfectly straight. So these are three different kinds of lines. So I want you to think of where you see different convergent, divergent, and parallel lines in your life. Maybe in nature, maybe on the street when you're driving, maybe in your house. Or how can you make a piece of artwork that shows each one of these in a different way? Maybe you want to make your own sticks with labels and little people, happy people, sad people, and aloof people. You know, they're chilling. They don't know. They're fine. But I want you to see if you can do something with it, because these are important geometric principles. Okay? All right, guys. Thank you so much. Talk to you later.